Blackstone Audio and Skyboat Media present The Sheep Look Up by John Brunner. This book is read by Stefan Rudnicki. To Isabel Grace Sauer, née Rosamond, 1887 to 1970, in memoriam. Please help keep pier clean. Throw refuse overside. Sign pictured in God's Own Junkyard, edited by Peter Blake. December. Prospectus. The day shall dawn when never child but may go forth upon the sward secure to play. No cruel wolves shall trespass in their nooks. Their lore of lions shall come from picture books. No aging tree a falling branch shall shed to strike an unsuspecting infant's head. From forests shall be tidy copses born, and every desert shall become a lawn. Lisping their stories with competing zest, one shall declare, I come from out the west, where grandpa toiled the fearful sea to take, and pen it tamely to a harmless lake. Another shall reply, my home's the east, where mama says dwelt once a savage beast, whose fangs he oft would bear in horrid rage. Indeed, I've seen one, safely in a cage. Likewise, the north, where once was only snow, the rule of halls and cottages shall know. The lovely music of a baby's laugh, the road, the railway, and the telegraph. And eke the south, the oceans round the pole shall be domestic. What a noble goal! Such dreams unfailingly the brain inspire, and to exploring Englishmen do fire. Christmas in the New Rome, 1862. Carnage. Hunted? By wild animals? In broad daylight on the Santa Monica Freeway? Mad, mad. It was the archetype of nightmare. Trapped, incapable of moving, with monstrous, menacing beasts edging closer. Backed up for better than a mile, three lanes trying to cram into an exit meant for two. Reeking and stalking, and roaring. For the time being, though, he was more afraid of running than of staying where he was. Bright fangs repeating the gray gleam of the clouds, a cougar, claws innocent of any sheath, a jaguar, winding up to strike, a cobra, hovering, a falcon, hungry, a barracuda. However, when his nerve finally broke and he tried running, it wasn't any of these that got him. But a stingray. Signs of the times. This beach not safe for swimming. Not drinking water. Unfit for human consumption. Now wash your hands. Penalty for noncompliance, $50. Filter mask dispenser. Use product once only, maximum 1 hour. Oxygen, 25 cents. Not in our stars. The radio said, you deserve security, stronghold style. Blocking access to the company parking lot on the left of the street was a bus, huge, German, articulated, electric, discharging passengers. Waiting impatiently for it to move on, Philip Mason pricked up his ears. A commercial for a rival corporation? The unctuous voice went on, backed by non-music from cellos and violas. You deserve to sleep undisturbed, to go on vacations as long as you can afford, free from worry about the home you've left behind. Don't they say a man's home is his castle, and shouldn't that be true for you? No, not insurance. Some dirty property developer. What the hell was this bus stopped here for, anyhow? It belonged to the city of Los Angeles, okay, right color, name painted on the side. But in place of a destination board, it just had a stock sign on hire, and he couldn't see details of its occupants through its grimy windows. But that was hardly surprising, since his own windshield was grimy, too. He had been going to hit the horn. Instead, he hit the wash and wipe stud, and a moment later was glad of the choice he'd made. Now he could discern half a dozen dull-faced kids, three black, two yellow, one white, and the head of a crutch. Oh. The speech from the radio continued, What we've done for you is build that castle. Nightly, armed men stand guard at all our gates, the only points of access through our spike-topped walls. Stronghold estates employ the best trained staff. Our watchmen are drawn from the police. Our sharpshooters are all ex-Marines, of whom there's no shortage since they kicked us out of Asia. Ah, the bus signaling a move. Easing forward past its tail, and noting from the corner of his eye a placard in its rear window which identified the hiring organization as...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.